Want to learn how to use pivot charts? In this video, I'll teach you everything you need to know. We're going to turn a list like this into a pivot table and two pivot charts with slicers to segment your graphs. Let's get started. Imagine you work for Tesla and your boss, Elon Musk, needs to present Cybertruck sales to the board. He chose you because he heard you're an Excel whiz, so it's your time to shine bright like a diamond. With this document showing sales by model, dealership, and year, you need to show two things. First, the percentage of sales the Cybertruck represents compared to other models. And second, how Cybertruck sales have increased year after year. Piece of cake for pivot tables and pivot charts. Let's start by calculating the sales share by model with a pivot table. Select any part of your data, then go to the Insert tab. There, choose the pivot table option. Quickly double-check that Excel has pre-selected all the data. It usually does, but better safe than sorry. Now, let's place our pivot table on a new sheet. Done. We said we need the percent of sales by model, right? So all we have to do is put the models in rows and the sales in values. Done. But what we want is not the number, but the percentage of the total. To show that, just select any cell in the sales column. Right-click, go to Show Values As, and choose Percentage of Column Total. Done. Okay, we have the data. Now let's create the pivot chart. With your pivot table selected, go to the Pivot Table Analyze tab and choose Pivot Chart. Excel will automatically add the chart it thinks is best for your data. However, these predictions aren't great. They almost always need changing. For example, in cases like this with percentage totals, a pie chart is best. To change it to a pie chart, select your pivot chart, go to the Design tab, and select Change Chart Type. All of Excel's chart options will appear, column charts, line charts, and exactly what we need, pie charts. Choose the simple pie chart, and boom, you've got your data. Much more understandable, right? Before moving on to the next chart and slicers, let's format this one in a few seconds. In the Design tab, go to Quick Layouts, which offers several pre-designed style options for your charts. You can try them all to see which one you like best, but I'll go with the first one. Done, way more understandable. Now I'll just change the title to Share of Sales per Model. Perfect. For the next pivot table, I'll show you a shortcut. Since the data source is the same, you can simply copy and paste the original and modify the fields. We were asked to show Cybertruck sales year by year, right? Okay, then add the years to the columns. Boom. We agree we don't need the percentages anymore, right? Let's revert this field to absolute values. Select any cell in your table, right-click, and under Show Values As, select No Calculation. We have the absolute values now. For the pivot chart, the process is the same. Go to the Pivot Table Analyze tab and select Pivot Chart. Again, Excel will give us a column chart. This time, it works. But I think it needs some changes because we have the models on the x-axis and columns for each year. Wouldn't it be clearer if the years were on the x-axis? To fix this with one click, go to the Design tab and click Switch Row / Column, which, as the name suggests, swaps the structure of your data. Boom. Much better, right? Now we can see how sales grew or shrank year by year. Oh, but one detail, Elon asked us to show only Cybertruck data. For that, we can use a slicer. With your pivot table selected, go to the Pivot Table Analyze tab and click Insert Slicer. A window will pop up where you can choose which fields to segment your data by. Since we want to show only Cybertruck data, select Model. Now just arrange it so it doesn't get in the way. Select the model you want to see, and presto. It's clear that Cybertruck sales have increased year after year. Now, what if you want to see more advanced stuff? Like year-over-year percentage changes or using calculated fields to figure out the profit margin for each model. Well, you can take my mini course on pivot tables, which I'll link here. See you there!